Okay, we are in front of the World of Dionysus. We are in Gallery 164, Hellenistic Art, 3rd century BC to 1st century AD. And what we're doing here, Dionysus, of course, was the god of wine, of ecstasy. He was the party god, basically, of the Greco-Roman world. But what's most important right here is that it is not hard to see why the middle and lower classes were also drawn to the cult of Dionysus, with its visions of an enchanted world where one could escape from everyday toils of life, their intoxicating wives, and experience the hope of salvation after death. So that's one of the key aspects right here that you see. How did the Romans think of death and the afterlife, pretty much? They feared it. They feared dying. Life was pretty miserable. Going forward, in this world, I think 70 to 80% of the people were slaves at this time, and they lived. A lot of people lived short and miserable lives. So there are some people who long for an afterlife, but the most prevailing thought, I think, during this time was that there is a Roman poet called Lucretius, who was a Roman philosophical poet, and he says that after death, there is nothing. There is no afterlife. If there are gods, they don't care about you. They're not going to help you out. So after you're dead, your soul dies at the same time. Because if you don't have a body, how can the soul live? So once you're dead, you're dead. So you don't have to fear death at all whatsoever. So just live and be merry, basically, and just have fun. Have as much fun as possible, eat, drink, and be merry, because tomorrow you die. Similar, you know, phrases that you've heard before. But then comes Paul. And what does Paul say, basically, to death? He says, don't fear death, right? He says, death, where is your sting? You know, you're going to be defeated, pretty much. So it's a very radical, very hopeful message that the gospel brings to the people. When people are reading and listening to the epistles of Paul and reading the Gospels, or listening to the Gospels, how radical it must have been to hear that there is more to life. Life doesn't end just at, you know, your physical death. It goes on to be with God later on. Whether or not you're a slave or a criminal, a leper, whoever, you are guaranteed to go to be in an afterlife afterwards. And the afterlife was only open to emperors, to the elite. If you were, you know, half God, half man, then you can go to heaven, basically. But to open it up to other people, to regular people, was such a radical and revolutionary idea that people never actually heard of it. It was very, very rare, basically, at this time. Okay, so we'll go on.